everybody. Welcome to my channel. Please forgive the helicopters. They're everywhere. They've been that way for the last week. I don't know why. I live in the hills up in Hollywood, and this is the first time that I've ever, I mean, the last couple of weeks, the helicopters have been flying over apartments, flying over the back side of the hills. I'm even seeing drones. So if you hear that noise in the background, just ignore it, please. I'm gonna go ahead and pull the shed for you in front of you instead of laying it out. Usually I like to lay it out first because it's so hard to do it all, and I'm gonna do a Celtic spread for you. This is for Scorpio, Sun, Moon, Rising. Present situation. This is a love reading, so take what resonates, leave the rest behind. If it doesn't resonate at all, it's not your read. Okay, this is your present situation. You're holding to your strength there and waiting on your ships to come in. Okay, it's the Three of Wands. Oh, wow. But jumped out for your challenge. Possibly a twin flame. That's your challenge. The Lovers. It's the first time that one's popped out in a while. And the Scorpio gets it. I'd like that to be my challenge. I'm super zingy. Not from Scorpio, though. We don't mesh well. Maybe Cancer is Scorpio. Okay. Your distant past. You were victorious. And you still are. Okay, that is your distant past. Let's see what your recent past is. So apparently you won somebody over in the distant past. Get you all dressed up with your wreath on and everything. Yeah, I'm from the South, so what? Oh, goodness gracious. Then we got the recent past and the best possible outcome. Okay. Oh, let's go through this here. You got two twin flame cards here, Scorpio. So, whoever you're dealing with is possibly your twin flame. I'm not going to call that because I don't know what your situation is. But you don't know everything in the situation here. This is your recent past. You don't know everything. I'm sitting pretty. Just there's some secrets. But they're both twin flame cards. 2, 2, 11, 11. Okay. Best possible outcome. is the Ace of Swords. And that is pretty much, I'm gonna make sure what it says, because it, yeah, it, that means victory, and that's what I thought, you know, because you got the wreath again. Look at all these wreaths. My goodness, wreaths and wreaths around your head. You guys in the Garden of Eden or what? Wow. Awesome read, Scorpio. Awesome read. So the best possible outcome is you win. And then the immediate future. We got, let's see what we got. So far, so good. Wow. But there are secrets. So keep your eyes peeled. And did I speak too soon? Because in your immediate future, you got the Tower. So this is something that's gonna shake your foundation up. Feel like the rug's been pulled out from underneath of you. And then in your factors affecting the situation, you get the Six of Pentacles, which is a good card. It's victory. It's sharing. It's fairness. So, that's the factors affecting the situation. Okay, let's find out what's next. External influences. External influences, the Queen of Cups. So are there two people here? Are you gonna need to make a choice? Or maybe somebody that you really, really like, somebody that's your twin flame? Because this is an external influence. Or it could be your mother. Loving, kind, good person. Lots of love and understanding and compassion. Okay. And we got the hopes and fears of the whole situation. And, looks like a fear to me, not a hope. The Nine of Swords. This is, loss, despair, disappointment. So that's what you're fearing in this situation. And if you're playing two people, then you might be a good reason for you to feel that way. And for your final outcome, I got the Ten of Pentacles. So, either way you go in this situation, the all-around energy is the Knight of Cups. Which somebody is bringing a message of love, regardless of who it is. You might have two choices, and one of them's going to shock you. That's probably what that's all about. But it's your Ten of Pentacles. It's getting what you want. And having every, you know, having everything you need. So like I said, take what resonates, leave the rest behind. Doesn't resonate, it's not your read. I hope you enjoy it. Got a lot of twin flame energy going around these days, so go with it. I mean, but if you're playing two people, don't play two people. Because you'll end up in that Nine of Swords energy. If it's just the one person in all three, and you're shocked. And worried. Stop it. Because everything else looks like it's going to work out just fine. Looks like this is a destiny situation. Okay? So, however that resonates with you, like I said, take what resonates and leave the rest behind. Cards, man. Let's flip them to the card. Okay? Alright, so that's that. Now we'll go with the goddess cards. I'm gonna pull you three of those. Oh no, that's a great reach, buddy. All except for the tower, but at least you know it's coming. Because that's your immediate future. Try not to be so shocked. And enjoy all that love you got coming. Because it looks like there's a lot of it. And you will win. Out. At least that's what the Rider-Waite Tarot says, anyway. Let's see what the goddesses and the angels got to say. This is for Scorpio, Sun, Moon, Rising. These are Ascension the Ascension cards, so I read them out to you. And this is your reality beyond appearances. Manifestation. So you're manifesting this twin flame. You're manifesting this lover. You're using your gifts, Scorpio. And Spirit's advice. Wow, it won't let me shuffle for you guys. Manipulation. Ruh-roh. Somebody trying to manipulate the situation and make it happen? That might be where the tower comes in. You can't manipulate people and make things happen, especially in a twin flame dynamic, because your twin flame's your twin for a reason. They are a part of you. They know what you're thinking. They know what you're feeling. In fact, they're feeling it too. So you can't get over on them. You can't manipulate them. You can't make something happen. We still got free will. No matter what this experiment or this evolution, ascension stuff that we're going through, we still have free will to choose. So if that other person does not choose you, you have to accept that and try not to manipulate the situation, because it's better that way. And the final outcome of that is the Ace of Realization. And I'll read those to you. And then we'll pull some angel cards. Ouch. Okay. Manifestation. I like that card. It's a cool looking card. When the goddess manifestation appears, her blessings are soon to follow. Prepare the way for your prosperity to come to you in all ways possible. inheritance, relationship, benefit, career change, good news. Take advantage of all the opportunities presented to you and open to her blessings. She brings the prosperous rewards you have been asking for. So, you're going to get what you want. You're going to get exactly what you want. Be careful what you wish for. Then Spirit's advice. Or whoever this is might be trying to manipulate you. You know, somebody's doing some manipulating here of a situation. This pitiful puppet is in your cards to show you that you are being manipulated or you're manipulating others. Need to control or be controlled comes from the lack of faith in life's process. Self-worth and identity issues are at the root of this. You are sacred. Have you been seduced by what is beneath you? Feeling you must manipulate others to get what you want? Now is the time to release the chaotic death grip. Remember who you are and let Spirit take the reins of your life. So that's Spirit's advice in the situation. Let go. Let go and let God. The Ace of Realization. I think you can imagine what that one says. This is the star, the goddess of starlit skies. Open to her immediate gifts of power and blessing for razor-sharp mental clarity. The star is bringing you the cosmic light of realization when you need it the most. Let her gifts pierce through stagnant attitudes and beliefs to activate your cellular memory and stellar vision. Open to a realization and then act upon your new understanding. Okay. All right. That looks like a twin flame read to me, Scorpio. Just like Pisces. I think Pisces. That's me. No, Pisces. Pisces got a bunch of twin flame energy too. So maybe the Scorpio and Pisces are all going through twin flame dynamics right now. It's supposed to be, some of us are supposed to be coming into union. I'm super single, so I don't know if that's going to happen for me or not. Then again, I'm not 25 or 30 years old either. But that was your read, Scorpio. I hope you enjoyed it. Please like, subscribe, and share if you did. And you guys have a great first beginning of the month. Looks like everything's kosher, and I will see you around the 15th. Take care now. Bye-bye.